Hi, I'm Piyush Rai. I worked in Cisco as a software engineer for around 2 years.
So Piyush, tell us, what is it that you worked on when you were part of Cisco?
Okay, so I come from an IT background, which is basically I don't have much knowledge about the hardware. I know the software part which I do and which I can work on. So basically, initially I started my work at Cisco developing some UI, some front-end things for the router and switches. So what happens is, not everyone can log into a router console and directly put in the commands which is needed to configure a router. Few people need a UI interface where they can directly give in the values, and based on the code, the algorithm which we write at the backend will push in the desired intent of the user to the device, and the device will work as he wants. This is one of the things which I... So basically the technologies which we used were like Node, AngularJS and all these things for developing front-end. It's very usual these days, most of the people use this technology. This is one of the things. Later, after a year or so, I moved into a project which was working, where I was involved in developing some RESTful APIs for the devices. So what happened was, this was a device which was supposed to take the input from the user as directly plain text, and based on that we were supposed to do some NLP and understanding what the user wants to do and get the intent out of the full text and then push in those things on the device and configure the whole system, the whole network across. So these are few of the coolest things which you can get to work. We have, like, if you're coming from a software background, you don't have to worry that you will be forced to work on full network or full hardware things, because we are having things like front-end, back-end, all these devices definitely need that. How will you communicate to a router or a switch which is kept in some other part of the country or some other part of the world only? So you need all these things which only we IT people can do. Networking is totally a different thing, but we all go hand in hand, and we develop things, they develop things, we club them up, and we are system.
Piyush, while you were at Cisco, how did you grow in terms of skills and experience in the time you were there?
Okay, so most of the concepts which you learn in college are like concerning the networking part. So you don't even get a chance to see an actual router or actual switch. How does it look like? What is a two rack router or a single rack router? Or how do you connect the cables? What all are the different ports behind the router? So once you come to Cisco, they have huge labs filled with n number of devices. You name a device, Cisco will have in networking. You can go to the lab, play around these devices, get to understand how a network works, what is a VLAN, what is a switch, what is a router, how do they work, what all are the different levels in the network architecture, where they fit in. These are all the things which are just floating inside the Cisco campus. The things which look very complex in college, you just walk around there and you'll hear around people, okay, they are talking about all these things, and your concepts will be cleared from that only. This was one of the things which I like cleared my concepts in routing, switching and networking. Apart from that, there are a lot of good training programs which Cisco has all across the year. So what happens is, you can choose whatever you want to learn or whatever you want to sharpen your skills on. So during my tenure, I attended few of the programs, like HTML5 was one in which I learned what are the coolest things which HTML5 can offer you in front-end development. Python is one language which is very easy to understand provided someone is there to guide you. So that was one of the things which I learned there. Apart from that, a lot of cloud-based courses and all these things were there. A lot of training materials, all these kind of things. Then I completed my CCNA degree when I was a part of Cisco at that time. So Cisco offers a free CCNA degree. If you clear the exam, it's full free. The fee money will be reimbursed to you. So these are the good things which you can get once you come to Cisco, enhance your career. And if you're really interested to go for an MTech degree, you can definitely have the Cisco program which allows you to do a part-time MBA, a part-time MTech from Prince Pilani. Thank you.